Hello Year 5 and welcome to Thursday's Piece of Learning. Today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be looking very closely at the writing that I have created that we looked at on Monday's lesson. So that story that I read out. And we're going to be thinking about the features that I put in that text. So for example, fronted adverbials and similes, all of those things that I know as a Year 5 pupil I would need to put into my writing, because I'm very well aware that we have not been at school for quite some time and I want to make sure that our brains are still ticking with knowing what we need to be including to make sure that our writing is always up to scratch. So what I would like you to do is open up the story from the very first lesson that I read to you. You can either listen to me reading it and follow along, or you can read it again independently yourself. And I would like you to write a list of all of the things that you think that I have included that are Year 5 expectations. So work out the brilliant features of this writing that I would be expecting you to be using in every single piece of writing that you do. Now, that might have taken you quite a bit of time because I've made sure to include lots of these features. Well done if you've got them all, that is absolutely fantastic. Well done if you've got some of them, that also is really good. If there are some of these that you have not got on your list, can you please pop them on the end, because this will come in really handy for tomorrow. So make sure that you keep these lists safe for what we are going to be doing later on. So the first thing that I would expect all of you to have put on is conjunctions, okay? And you might have gone even further by saying about coordinating and subordinating conjunctions. Now remember, a coordinating conjunction will blend together two sentences that are main clauses. So two sentences that are really important and you have to have. If you've got subordinating conjunctions, that will blend together a main clause and a subordinate clause. Now that main clause is something that makes sense on its own that you need in that sentence, and your subordinate clause is part of your sentence that just adds a little bit of extra information, but it does not make sense on its own. So remember, fanboys is coordinating, and I saw a wubub is subordinating. Now clauses, you might have gone again one step further by saying about embedded, relative and subordinate clauses. So essentially these subordinate and embedded clauses and relative clauses add in extra pieces of information into your text using brackets, dashes or commas. So an embedded clause is just like the example that I've put here. Her hat, which concealed her shy eyes, was made from straw. That is in the middle, sandwiched in the middle of that main clause. A relative clause actually is this one as well, because it contains the word which. We spoke about this a little bit earlier on. Next, we have got short sentences. I want you to have a think. Why have I included short sentences there? I'm going to give you 10 seconds just to have a think. What is the effect of using lots of short, snappy sentences? And very well done if you said that short, snappy sentences create lots of tension. It really builds suspense. It makes the reader think, oh my goodness, what is happening? And makes them read faster because they want to know what is going to happen. So that helps build suspense and tension. The next thing that you might have identified are similes and metaphors. Now remember, a simile, is saying that something is like something else, or as something else. It's comparing two things. So for example, as fast as a cheetah. But a metaphor is saying that something is something else, even though it's not. So for example, my brother is a pig. This means it's because they're a little bit greedier, so they're eating a bit like a pig would. The next thing that you might have identified is personification. So again, we've spoken about personification before a couple of weeks ago. Personification is when an object is said to be doing something that a human can do, even though in real life it actually can't. So, for example, a plane can't actually open its mouth and scream. But if you say the plane screamed as it landed, it means that it made a loud noise as it was landing. This is definitely something I really hope that a lot of you would have put in your checklist. Fronted adverbials. We've been working really hard on these fronted adverbials, year five. Remember that comma needs to go after them. It says when, where, and how something happens, and that is at the beginning of the sentence, at the front of the sentence. So, for example, in the blazing sun, comma. In the blazing sun is saying where something happened. When, you could have 500 years ago. So 500 years ago, comma. And saying how something happened, well, actually, you can maybe use a simile for this. As fast as a cheetah, comma. It's saying how that person is maybe running or sprinting. Next is your expanded noun phrases. Remember, we did this again last week. So it says about the determiner, the adjective, the noun, and the prepositional phrase, and it brings it all together. Feel free to rewind to a couple of weeks ago when we did talk about that to have a recap if you're not sure. So the is your determiner, hairy is your adjective, cat is your noun, and on the bed is your prepositional phrase, so the position of the cat. That is really, really important to be including in your writing year five in order to give the reader the best picture in their head of what is going on. Next is adverbs. This is something that lots of you, myself included, forget about when we're writing. We've got so many ideas and we're writing, and then we have to go back and think, oh no, we need to give the reader as much information as possible. So please don't forget those. Remember, adverbs are how the verb is happening, for example, loudly or cautiously. Now, this next one, I will be extraordinarily impressed if any of you manage to get, because this is something that I would like to introduce to you. This is called onomatopoeia, and this is how a word, it's spelt how it is sounded. So, for example, if something buzzes, it's spelt just like you would say it, buzz. And the same with bang. If you hear a bang noise, this is how it is, exactly how it's spelt. And meow. When a cat meows, if they were to write down exactly it as they said it, it would be spelt like this. Have a think. Can you think of any more of those? It would be interesting to see if you could add them to your list a little bit later on. This is one also I would really, really hope that you would get year five, a variety of punctuation. Don't just put your full stops and your capital letters there. Make sure that you've got your apostrophes, make sure you've got your capital letters, make sure you think you've got your exclamation marks, your question marks, your dashes, your brackets. Make sure that you've got all of those really important things to make it as engaging as possible for the reader. And the last one, again, I would imagine the majority of you would have, are rhetorical questions. Remember, rhetorical questions are questions that are not answered, are not expected to be answered. So, for example, if I was a meaner teacher, I might say to some of you, can't you do anything right? And I wouldn't expect a reply to that. For your task today, what I would like you to do is go back and skim and scan through that text that we looked at on that first day of slavery, the story about slavery when the person was running from her captors and ended up on the slave ship. And I would like you to identify these things that are now on your list or that you should have updated on your list so that we all have the same. Now, if you're not feeling quite as confident on this, I would like you please to complete the red features. So conjunctions, short sentences, similes, fronted adverbials, expanded noun phrases, a variety of punctuation, and rhetorical questions. I would like you to look through my text and pick out one or two examples of conjunctions or short sentences that I've used. And then I would like you to come up with three more of your own that might fit the story or a very similar story. Learning could look like this. Here I've taken fronted adverbials. I've chosen some examples that I've found from the text. And then I've thought of what a fronted adverbial is. And I've created three of my own examples. If you would like to push yourselves, I would like you to do every single one on here. So picking out one or two from the text and then coming up with three of your own, or maybe more than three if you would like to impress me.
I look forward to seeing the learning that you've produced today, Year 5. I'm very intrigued to see whether you've been able to find all of the things on that checklist, and if you'd be able to come up with some creative ones of your own. Please send them through to the Year 5 email so we can all take a little look at them. We've all been impressed so far with the fantastic things that you have been doing. Keep it up, Year 5. Well done.